The human mind wants to worry. This is not necessarily a bad thing. After all, if a bear is stalking you, worrying about it may well save your life. However, we do not really need to lose too much sleep because of some unnecessary worrying. Hi guys, this is Prateek and welcome to Eclectic. Here we talk about our past, present and the future. However, in this particular series of short videos, we are going to focus on how to make our present better. The American surgeon and psychiatrist William Samuel Sadler described worry as an inability to relax the attention once it had fastened itself onto a given fear. He wrote that in his 1950s book, Worry and Nervousness. All people experience negative or troubling thoughts. But for those who worry too much, Sadler wrote, those negative thoughts are stickier and eventually they can become destabilizing. Flash forward 100 years and mental health experts today echo many of Sadler's sentiments. Worry is a part of human nature. If people did not worry, they wouldn't be able to anticipate and prepare for life's challenges. For some people though, worry gets to be overwhelming. People who worry a lot tend to become depressed. One could argue that recent world and domestic events as well as the social and professional lifestyle justify anxiety and a negative outlook. But a new study in the journal Behavior Therapy finds that many of the worries that occupy an anxious mind never come to fruition. They just never become a reality. Roughly 6.8 million Americans, means about 3% of the population, have generalized anxiety disorder GAD, according to the Anxiety and Depression Association of America. For the study, researchers at Penn State University asked 100 people with GAD disorder to write down everything they worried about for 1 month. The study participants also recorded the outcomes of their worries. The researchers found that 91% of people's worries did not come true. For several of the people, exactly none of the things they worried about actually happened. Even on those rare occasions where a person's worry translated to reality, the outcome was often better than the person had feared. When presented with this evidence that their worries were largely unfounded, many of the people in the study experienced improvements in their anxiety symptoms. So we can help people who worry too much by proving to them that their feared outcomes did not happen as often as they thought. And even when it did happen, the outcome was better than they had expected. We could help them see that worrying is not helpful and it is not going to bring any real change in their life. In the book The Worry Cure by Robert Leahy, there are two techniques which can help you in reducing your worries and anxiety. The first one, write down your negative predictions and test them out. See how often they become reality. I assure you that more than 90% of the time, your worries, your negative thoughts will never become a reality. The second technique is to set aside a block of time each day for worrying. Allocate a specific time and place to think about your fears. It may sound odd, but a lot of people find it easier to take their mind off a concern if they have granted themselves a specific time and place to pick it back up. It helps them escape from the constant anxiety. So sit down, get relaxed at your scheduled time and think about your worries. This tactic will help you escape from round-the-clock anxiety. And who knows, when the scheduled time arrives, the thing you were worrying about will no longer be a concern. There is no one-size-fits-all cure for anxiety or worrying. Worrying and anxiety often takes years to build up, and so it is unlikely to go away in a day or a week. But with a mix of techniques, and in some cases with therapist attention, it can be shrunk down to size. No matter how effective you are at reducing worries, you are not going to eliminate them completely. Unpleasant thoughts and negative emotions are part of the human condition. But always remember, no matter how bad your predictions are, they are very less likely to become a reality.
You belong in the most secret part of you. Don't worry about cool. Make your own uncool. Make your own world. If you fear, make it work for you. Draw and paint your fear and anxiety, and stop worrying about big, deep things such as to decide on a purpose and way of life, a consistent approach to even some impossible end or even an unimagined end. You must practice being stupid, dumb, unthinking, empty. Then you will be able to do. You are not responsible for the world. only responsible for your work, so just do it! When you work, or before you work, you have to empty your mind and concentrate on what you are doing. After you do something, it is done, and that's that.
On my channel, I make videos on our past, present, and the future, which involves dealing with the history, philosophy, politics, and the future tech. Go ahead, check out the playlist and videos that are already available. Subscribe if you find them interesting. And also, I assure you that more interesting content will keep coming up. If it is possible for you, economically support my channel on patreon.com.